Guys, I'm really running out of things to do here. Can't do this for long, I'm getting red. Ugh.
Hey peeps, my name is Ilya and welcome to the vlog. If you're like me, anywhere around the world pretty much at this point, you're probably stuck at home in isolation or self-isolation, trying to keep the world around you safe and also going mad from not knowing what to do with your time, because as a creative you probably have a lot less jobs, a lot less assignments, so you're like, what can I do in this weird time period? Maybe that doesn't apply to you, but that's pretty much me in this situation. So I compiled a list of 10 things a creative person could do while in isolation, primarily for me. Maybe you can use them as well. So I'm gonna start with the first one, which is personally my favorite, and that is learning something new. That is my utmost passion, right above traveling somewhere, because traveling also includes a lot of learning, but it can be learning a new musical instrument, learning a type of new art form, learning to do something with your hands, DIY, handyman type things like that. It's proven to be a great boost to your creativity. So just, you know, search the internet for what new things you can learn and dive right in. If you're not into learning new things, or you don't think you have the motivation to learn something completely new, maybe you can practice inside the sphere that you already do regularly, but maybe pick an aspect of that you haven't tried so much. For example, if you're a photographer like me, maybe you haven't tried product photography or making flat lays or experimenting with lighting, or maybe you have a drone and you can throw it out your window and have it fly around the neighborhood and see what cool shots you can do with that. Of course, depending on the regulations in your country. Maybe you've never done a time lapse, so you just put a camera on your balcony when it's sunset and see what happens. One thing that I'm ashamed to admit I have not done in a long while is update my portfolio. My portfolio on my website is probably 2 years old, and when someone asks me to send my portfolio, I just compile some of my most recent work and send it to them. This is a great time to actually update that and have a functional online portfolio which anyone can look at any time. You should do that too. You hear a lot of YouTubers and photographers talk about this, but it's still not as popular as it could be, and that is stock photography and videography. Yes, photography is kind of a saturated market, but video is a pretty new thing. There's a site called Black Box. I'm obviously not sponsored by them, but they're awesome. You pretty much upload your footage and they send it out to a whole bunch of stock sites. So if you're the type of person who archives all their filming and things like that, then this is a perfect time to go through all your archives, pull out that footage that could make it onto a stock videography site, and then later down the line you just might sell it and make some profit off of it. There are tons of people whose primary income comes from stock videography, so it's definitely a topic worth exploring since you have all the time in the world. If you're not so much into selling your content, but you do publish it on social media, maybe it's the time to step up your social media game. So if you post a photo on Instagram 3 times a week, this is a great time to dig into your archives, maybe do a relapse and start posting 5 times a week. If you make 1 YouTube video per week, maybe you should try making 2 YouTube videos per week. Even if you will not be able to continue with the regularity after this period of weird time is over, it is definitely bound to help your growth in a way. If you're the type of person that doesn't like social media so much and is struggling with marketing your art, maybe it's a great time to experiment with building a social media account. If you already have one, maybe you post to Facebook and YouTube but not Instagram, or you post to Facebook and Instagram and you hate TikTok, maybe it's a great time to experiment and find out the potential that each platform absolutely does have. Hint, hint, go to TikTok. If you're not the type who's into social media at all, then maybe you can look into other alternative things like starting a blog or a mailing list or other things like that. There are a great funnel for sharing your work and also marketing if you're into that kind of thing. But then if you don't like social media, it's a great alternative. Speaking of blogs and newsletters, it is also a good time to open a new side business, whether it's related to your art or not. There are tons of online things you can do, like drop shipping or selling a digital product, which doesn't require much capital to start up, but has proven to be a great source of income for a lot of people out there. I've been pushing this off for a long, long time. Maybe it's time to start digging into that and, you know, planting the roots for what might potentially be my business. Here's another one I've been pushing off for a while, and that is compiling your old gear, like that pulley over. Wait. See this pulley over here? I bought it, used it for 1 or 2 events, and then it's been on my shelf ever since. Compile it, take pictures, and put it up for sale, because with all the gear you can sell, you can probably buy a newer, better piece of gear that you'll actually use. Yeah. And the last one, which is very general, that is changing up your surroundings, whether it's painting your wall a different color or just moving your furniture around, building a desk like I did over here a little while back. And that is proven to help get your creative juices flowing, to maybe help you create something new in the sphere that you generally work in already. Those are some of the things that I'm planning to do in the upcoming days of isolation. I hope that was beneficial to you too. Since you have all the time in the world, why don't you go check out my Instagram where I post photos of what I do in isolation or not in isolation. I went out to nature the other day, which is the next best thing, I guess. And believe it or not, I am also on TikTok where I put behind the scenes videos and attempted funny videos. So go check them out. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm gonna see you in the next video, whenever that happens. I hope I was recording. Yeah, all good.